ये कुछ बेटा
हेलो
स्टार्ट
हेलो हेलो सर
सर यू कैन स्टार्ट योर सेशन.
ओके मैम थैंक यू. Okay. Good morning, dear students. This is Sudhala Harish, PGD English, TSRS and JC for Boys, Kochambad. Now, I am going to teach you Unit 3, Humanity. Reading A, The Selfish Giant 1. Okay, dear students, now, what do you see here in this picture? So here we see a lady in white, and the lady is taking care of a baby. We don't know whether the baby is a girl or a boy. So, but she is looking after the baby. And now, who do you think this lady in white is? Yes, she is none other than Mother Teresa, who doesn't need any introduction in the world because she is one of the greatest personalities, one of the greatest humanists and the noblest personalities in the world, all over the world. Because she dedicated her entire life to caring of the destitute, for the people, for the homeless and everyone. Now here we can see in this picture, she is taking care of a boy. Now she doesn't have any relationship, a baby. She doesn't have any relationship with this baby. Though she is doing something in favor of the baby. So this is called humanity. Humanity is a compassionate, sympathetic, generous behavior or disposition is called humanity. I know, so let's talk about humanity in simpler words. Humanity is the quality of being kind to people or animals by making sure that they do not suffer more than necessary. Okay, now here, let's talk about Mother Teresa a bit more. See, actually her full name is Agnes Gongsha Boyacciu. She was born in Skopje, Macedonia in 1910. She was an Albanian Indian Roman Catholic nun. She came to India in 1929, and in her entire life, she worked for the welfare of the poorest of the poor, and also for the homeless, and for orphan children, and also for the people who were dying from the terminus illness. Terminus illness means diseases which did not have any treatment, like HIV/AIDS, tuberculosis, leprosy, such diseases. And Mother Teresa, she founded the Missionaries of Charity Center in Calcutta, which is now called Kolkata, in 1950. The main objective of this Missionaries of Charity Center was to provide support to the people who needed it the most. So this Missionaries of Charity Center, now it comprises 4,500 nuns who are actively working in more than 600 missions across 133 countries all over the world. See, she dedicated her entire life to caring for the destitute and dying in the slums of Kolkata. After her death, she was honored the title. So she was honored the title Saint Teresa in Catholic Church. Usually, this title, the saint, this title is attributed to some in Christianity to someone who dedicated their life for the wellness or for the well-being of people. So, in recognition of her services, in recognition of her dedication, in recognition of the love she showed for the mankind in her entire life, she was given a large number of awards and distinctions. And she almost won 125 awards, but among all those awards, the most prestigious ones are the Nobel Peace Prize, and she won it in 1979, and the highest civilian award of India, which is Bharat Ratna, she won it in 1980. So we can now, on seeing all these, so on seeing the dedication she showed to the love of mankind in the all over the world, especially in India, we can tell that she is the icon of humanity. So obviously, she is one of the noblest personalities in the world. Okay, students, now let's talk a bit more about humanity. Now, see this picture. See, what do you see in this picture? Here, see, we can see a man. So, okay, he seems to be rich. Though he is in a t-shirt and a short, he seems to be rich, right? But you know, he is passing by a road, and he happened to see a girl. See, on seeing her physical appearance, we can assume that she is very poor, right? And now we can see here, on seeing the shadow of this, it seems to be very hot and very sunny. So in order to favor the girl, you know, to shield her soles of her legs from the heat, this man is giving his slippers to that girl. Yes, we know he doesn't have any relationship with this girl, though he is giving his slippers to this girl. Why? Because this man is kind. He has the quality of humanity. So we can say that this is an example of humanity. Let's see one more picture. See here, in this picture, see, this boy also seems to be poor. See, on seeing the kind of dress he is wearing, we can assume that he is poor. Now he has some eatables in his hand, some food in his hand. Now, in spite of his poverty, in spite of his poverty, he is still feeding an animal from the limited food that he has. So this quality means, no matter whether you are rich or poor, when you have the quality of giving something to someone from the whatever limited resource you have, is called humanity. Let's see one more picture. See here, in this picture, you can see this 2-year little boy. See how feeble he is. He looks as if he is on the verge of death. See how feeble he is. Now we can see a lady is drinking water to the boy. In this picture, see, now see, this 2 year naked and this naked and 2 year dying abandoned child. So this child was abandoned in Nigeria. See, in Nigeria, you know, people, see, this child was abandoned by his or her own parents. You know, he was being, not only this child, many children in Nigeria were accused of being witches. I don't know why there. So such a child who was abandoned by taking care of this lady, her name is Anya Ringren Loven. So she has been working for the abandoned children since last 8 years. She is from Denmark. See, she has established a charity organization which looks after such children. See here, see the child in the left picture and in the right picture. See this, the same child who is in the left picture some 2 years ago, now is in the, see, this child has become like this now. See, so you can imagine what kind of care this lady took of this child. He has become like this now. So this is called humanity. See, helping someone who is unfamiliar to you, expecting nothing in return, that is called humanity. You know, in a movie, in a Telugu movie, Mahesh Babu says that helping the help done to someone who is unfamiliar to us, nothing expecting in return, that is called, that quality is called humanity. Now you I think every one of you might be aware of this man. He is none other than Sonu Sood, one of the Indian actors. Now he, okay, basically he plays villain characters in real, but now he is hailed as a real life hero because of the charitable deeds he has been doing for the last 1.5 years. See, in 2020, during nationwide lockdown, which was due to COVID-19 pandemic, so this man, this Bollywood actor, you know, helped a lot of some lakhs of migrants who were trapped, deserted in the cities they were working. So he helped them reach their homes by arranging buses, special trains and chartered flights. You know, see here, in this college, see, in this image, we can see the bus. In first two images, we can see the buses he arranged for the Indian migrant workers. And see here, in this picture, now Sonu Sood happened to see a viral video in which an elderly woman, you know, performing some martial arts just to earn a living for her in the streets of Pune. So he happened to see that video, and through social media he got her contact details, and he opened a training school with that elderly woman to train women for learning some self defense techniques. So Sonu Sood, you know, there are many richer celebrities than Sonu Sood in India, you know, who did nothing, but Sonu Sood is not richer than many other celebrities, though he helped, you know, from whatever he had, he helped a lot. Now he is called a real life hero. See here, in this picture, we can see a tractor with three women. Now Sonu Sood happened to see one more viral video, and this was from Chittoor, Andhra Pradesh district. In that video, you know, a farmer was ploughing his field, you know, with his daughters, with his daughters, having the yoke on their shoulders. So on that, on seeing that video, his heart was moved, and immediately the next day he sent a tractor to that farmer, and he showed his humanity levels. And see here, here we can see the Sonu Sood ambulance service. Now on seeing Sonu Sood's humanity levels, you know, the Spice Jet honored him, you know, with having his photo on the flight. You can see here a salute to the savior Sonu Sood. He became a savior in the lockdown period. Now see, we can also see here a statue was established by the fans of Sonu Sood for his helping hand. So this is, so we can say, you know, through these pictures we can say what humanity is. Now I can understand what I can so I hope you have understood what humanity is. Now in simpler words to say, dear children, humanity is nothing but it is forgiveness. Sometimes, you know, usually you being children, you make some mistakes in the classrooms or in the school campus. But teachers, even though knowing that you have made some mistake, even though having a cane in their hands, they do not punish you. That is because of the humanity they have. And humanity is also help. For example, you are eating something, and the child next to you or your friends, they do not have anything to eat. You know, sharing your food, whatever you have, with them is called humanity. So like this we can say humanity. Humanity is nothing but the quality of being kind towards people and animals. Okay, see, look at the picture given below. See here, what do you see in this picture? We can see a girl. So this girl is giving some food to the man, to a very poor man apparently. So what do you know, this is we notice in this picture. And so what would be the reaction of that man? Yes, when someone receives some help from us, obviously, you know, they would be very happy, and in their eyes we can see a kind of feeling of gratitude. Have you ever seen such incidents? What is your opinion on them? Yes, we see, we have seen many such incidents in the pictures we have seen so far. And what's your, everyone's opinion on humanity, on helping to some other people? Definitely would be good. We must, being a human, we must help people or anyone around us as much as we can. So let's now, the lesson we are going to learn here is The Selfish Giant, part 1. So before that, let's learn something about the author. The author of this lesson, The Selfish Giant 1, is Oscar Wilde. So he was born on 16th October in 1854. He passed away on 30th November in 1900. So he was an Irish writer and poet. So after writing in different forms throughout the 1880s, he became one of London's most popular playwrights in the early 1890s. Today, he is remembered for his epigrams and plays. You know, epigrams are nothing but short poems, especially satirical ones, you know, with a witty and ingenious ending. You know, Oscar Wilde is best known for the novel The Picture of Dorian Gray and the play The Importance of Being Earnest. The Happy Prince and Other Tales is a collection of children's stories. Okay, now let's enter the lesson. The Selfish Giant. This is a one-act play. usually a one act play, a one act play is a play which has only one act. You know, usually one act plays have one or more scenes. You know, depicts about a particular incident which happened only in one setting. Now let's see the title here, The Selfish Giant. Now we have come to know the meaning of humanity, which is the name of our unit. Now here, the selfish giant, see here, the word selfish. Selfish is quite opposite, it is contradict to the title of our unit, humanity. Humanity is, you know, the quality of being kind to animals or people. But here, selfish is the quality of caring only about oneself, not anyone or anything about anyone, not caring about anyone else or anything else. So here, the quality the quality of caring about only oneself, it means I, you know, these the people who are selfish, they always think about themselves, they care about themselves, they do not care anything what's going on around them. And instead of not caring, they try to exploit the situation. It means instead of not helping some others, you know, they loot, or they try to grab they try to grab something from the others. So that is selfish quality. So here, giant means, you know, a person who is unusually large, much larger than the similar things, than the things usually are. A person who is unusually big in size is called giant. So here, the selfish giant. Now in the play we are going to learn, there is a giant, and that giant is very selfish. So this giant does not care about anyone else, it is self-centered giant. Okay, now in the key theme of this selfish giant is how selfishness leads, what selfishness leads to. You know, selfishness ultimately leads to self-defeating or self-destructiveness. We will come to know how, what kind of consequences the giant will face and how it will come out of such bad consequences. Okay, now let's enter the lesson. So here, old giant and the giant refer to the same character. The giant is a selfish character, whereas old giant is a changed and kind character. An old giant addresses the audience directly. The action plays out behind him as he describes it. See here, in the play we are going to learn there are two names, old giant and the giant. Actually, the old giant and the giant, these two names do not refer to two characters, but they refer to the same character. Old giant is when he becomes old. The giant is a selfish character. It means when this giant was younger, he was selfish. But when this giant was younger, it was selfish. And when this giant becomes old, you know, it has changed its character into a kind one. So now here, usually a play is played on a stage. Now here, the character of old giant, you know, the one, whoever plays the character of old giant, he stays before the stage and he addresses the audience directly. It means he describes what happened in the past. So children, you have to use your imagination here, only then you can understand the play. Now here someone stands there before the stage and he plays the character of old giant, and he describes what happened in the past, and whatever happened in the past, that is played on the stage by some other characters. So here the action plays out, it means the plays out, you can see the meaning here, happens, the action happens behind him on the stage. Okay children, I hope you have understood. Okay, now the old giant is referring, I once owned a large lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there were 12 peach trees that in the spring time broke out into delicate blossoms of pink and pearl, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. The birds sat on the trees, sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. So this old giant is describing, see, once, now I have already told you, now he has become old. So when he was young, he owned a garden, and how was that garden? The garden was large, lovely, and in that garden, the garden was completely with soft green grass. So in that garden, here and there, some 12 peach trees are there. You can see peach trees. See, this is the peach tree and these are the peach fruits. So usually, you know, all trees in the springtime, they break out. It means trees start to begin into delicate blossoms. So here in this garden, these peach trees, they used to break out in spring season into delicate blossoms of pink and pearl, and till autumn they bore, it means they became rich fruit. So in that garden some birds were also there, and they used to sing so sweetly, so melodiously, that even the children used to stop their games just to listen to the songs of those birds. And every afternoon, as those children were coming from school, they used to go and play in my garden. See here, the giant stresses on my. See here, I'm stressing this word my. You can understand how selfish that giant is. Okay. So every afternoon, when they were coming from school, they used to go to the garden and they used to play in that garden. But one day this giant came back from where? Let's see from where. Wait a minute, children. There is some problem here. Just a minute, children. There is a problem. Some problem here. Right. Okay, children. Let's see. From see here. Now we said peach trees. We have seen here. See. Trees, they have round fruit with soft red and yellow skin. Springtime, see the difference between spring and autumn. Let's see here. Usually seasons are divided into four: winter, spring, summer and monsoon. See, this is in India, winter season starts. Winter season is peak in December and January, and the climate in winter season is very cool. And spring season starts in February and it lasts till March, and the climate in spring season is sunny and pleasant. And after spring, you know, this spring in April turns warmer and it becomes summer. From April to June, it is very hot, and that is summer. And see here, monsoon is nothing but in India, autumn is divided into two. So in early autumn, we get in early autumn in India is called monsoon. It lasts from July to mid September, and it rains in these months. And when it does not rain, the weather is hot and humid. So let's see the meanings of earlier paragraph. Breakout means to develop or emerge with suddenness. Delicate blossoms means tender flowers. You know, the early stage of flowers is called tender flowers. Autumn is the season between summer and winter. See here, I said the giant came back from where? See, old giant again is whistling. I had been to visit my friend, the Garnish Augur, and had stayed with him for 7 years. After the 7 years were over, I had said all that I had to say, and I determined to return to my own castle. When I arrived, I saw children playing in my garden. So this giant, so when it was young, what happened? See, before the now old giant is telling that he came back to the garden. Before that, he had gone to visit his friend Garnish Augur. See, Garnish Augur means, Augur means a giant. Garnish means he was a giant of Cornwall in UK. Okay, so he went to visit his friend. He had gone to visit his friend Garnish Augur, and after going to his friend, he had stayed with him for 7 long years. And in those 7 long years, he had said all that he had to say to his friend. And then when he's saying, all his sayings were over to his friend, he decided to come back to his own castle. Castle means a large strong building with strong and thick walls. That is called castle. So he decided to come back to his castle, and when he arrived, to his surprise, he saw some children playing in his garden. And then he asked, "What are you doing here?" When he asked, the children ran away. The children ran away into the directions whichever were possible to them. So then he said, "My own garden is my own garden. Anyone can understand that, and I will allow nobody to play in it but myself." On seeing, see, by these sentences we can understand that how selfish he is. He is very selfish that, you know, even if children play in his garden, nothing will happen to his garden, right? Though he says, "My own garden is my own garden. Anyone can understand that, and I will allow nobody to play in it but myself." So when, see, I told you the one who is standing before the stage is describing the verse. So then the old giant points out to the younger giant, whoever is playing the character of the giant on the stage. So he was, what was he doing? He was working on a wall, putting up a sign, and he was listening at the wall. What was he listening? See, so when he saw the children playing there, he asked them, "Who are you?" Then they ran away. So he built a high wall all around and put up a notice board. And what was there on that notice board? "Trespassers will be prosecuted." What does trespassers mean? Trespassers means persons who go into a piece of land without permission. So such people are called trespassers. And prosecuted. Prosecuted means to bring a legal action against for punishment of a crime or violation of a law. So now the meaning of this sentence is trespassers will be prosecuted. If anyone without permission comes into my garden, you know, a legal action will be taken against them. So this is the meaning of this sentence. So then I heard the children whispering outside the wall on their way to school. So the old giant is telling that, so he was putting up a sign on the wall, and then he was listening. What was he listening? The children were whispering. Whispering means speaking quietly. So the children were whispering. Let's come to know what they were whispering in the next class. But before, see, children, you can see here the giant. When the giant came here, all the children, they are running away from the giant. They are escaping from the giant. Now see here, in the last slide we have seen trespassers will be prosecuted. The above line, see, this line gives all outsiders a caution not to enter it without permission, right? So such cautionary sentences are called one line notices. You know, usually we see such cautionary sentences are one line notices in some public places, right? So these usually these one line notices are put in public places to make general public aware of the rules and regulations to be followed in those particular areas or places. Let's see some such sentences. So let's see some examples here. We see such cautionary sentences or one line notices in some religious places, be it a temple, mosque or church. We observe or we find such sentences, this kind of sentence: shoes must be removed before entering, take your shoes off before entering. So this such cautionary sentence or one line notice we find in religious places. And at bus stops, what sentences do we find at bus stops? Smoking is prohibited here, or smoking is an offense here. We see such sentences at bus stops. And in some gardens we find these kind of sentences: walking on the grass is not allowed. So we see this kind of sentences in gardens. So I hope you have understood what one line notices are. I repeat once again.